seeing other people using the conference for everything, for learning, but also the networking. Someone in our community, someone that we know, actually had a wonderful opportunity come up from this. You know, they found there could be a potential employment opportunity. There's lots of calls that will be happening as a result, but it was a wonderful experience. That person was able to go around and hand out business cards, meet with these people. And when people said, hey, you should talk to so-and-so, they were actually to go and introduce them to the person. So it was really, really nice and uplifting to see that coming out to the conference actually can help people and will help people if they do the right things of networking and not being too afraid to reach out to people.
Hello and welcome to the PyBytes podcast, where we talk about Python, career, and mindset. We're your hosts. I'm Julian Sequeira.
And I am Bob Beldebos. If you're looking to improve your Python, your career, and learn the mindset for success, this is the podcast for you. Let's get started. Welcome back to the PyBytes podcast. This is Bob Eldebos. I'm here with
Julian Sequeira.
Physically in the same place.
We're together. We're together at the same
time. Where are we? kind of obvious, I think.
Yes. Right now,
Pittsburgh.
Yeah. So we are at Pittsburgh, in Pittsburgh, in Pennsylvania, in the US, for the Python convention, PyCon US 2024. We're actually not at the convention right now. It's Monday morning. The sprints
done.
Yeah, the conference done. Sprints are taking place.
Sprints are still taking place, but
yeah. So we're pretty tired. So we're actually just recording this from this beautiful apartment that we got, you know, through Airbnb or something like that. And it's awesome. So we'd love to show you the view for those of you watching on YouTube, but the cameras are.
Just imagine the Pittsburgh skyline.
Exactly. So. We're going to keep this pretty crisp and pretty to the point, but we wanted to share a few thoughts from PyCon 2024 US, now that it's done, and just what we thought about it, what some of the highlights were for us, some tips, all that sort of thing. So do you want to go first?
Sure. Of course, there were a lot of interesting talks, and a lot of them I did not attend because, which will probably the next bullet point is the people, but a few I did, and I watched the Charlie Marsh rough talk, and he really got into how these speed ups with Rust worked. I went to a couple of code quality talks, one by the author of Robust Python, and that was very interesting. So I did that mostly the first day, and then of course we got into networking and meeting up with all these beautiful people. And you know, the talks will be on YouTube, so I made a deliberate choice. But again, as always with conferences, you come here and you get a lot of inspiration and ideas. There was more AI, of course. But overall, the talks, there was also a great variety. So now, as always, after a conference, I come back home. I'm hungry. I want to learn more. And I think that's a unique feature of PyCon.
Yeah, it was. And I think a key point that Bob made is that don't feel pressure to attend every talk. Obviously, if it's from someone that you've been dying to see or that sort of stuff, prioritize it. But if you can't make every talk, it's okay. I mean, many of the talks happen at the exact same time, so you're going to have to choose anyway. But it was such a cool experience because you randomly run into people and you might think, oh, crap, I've got to go to this talk, but I want to see this person. And it's okay to miss it because it's going to be recorded anyway. And actually, the app this year allowed you to stream the talks live as they were happening through the app, I think. So that was pretty cool. But that leads to the next point, which is people. And by far and large, the most valuable and special thing about coming all this way, because you traveled how many hours?
End to end, 23 hours.
Yeah.
I think you did 27, right?
27, not including the commute to the airport. So it was a long way, but it was so worth it because we got to meet with so many people, meet the PyBytes community. That was super special. We had that community meetup on Saturday, but we got to meet all of our friends, people that we've connected with over the past 6 to 7 years, catch up and talk about new opportunities and partnerships and all these sorts of things. So the networking, the connection with other human beings in this space is completely understated. Before you get here, you just don't even think it's going to be that much or that impressive. But like a perfect example, you know, Bob was having a good chat with Michael Kennedy from the Talk Python to Me podcast. And even though we communicate with Mike over email quite often and that sort of stuff, it was because we were in person having this chat that this potential opportunity and partnership came up. So
yeah, I think it's time and space. You can have a virtual coffee chat, but you're never going to sit for 3 hours at a bar with drinks. And
yeah,
and that space creates a lot of depth, and that's unique, I think.
Yeah, exactly right. So what else was on the list?
Plus, people needed the proof that we're not some AI, that we're actually...
Yeah, we are real people.
We exist in the physical dimension.
Yeah. He's going to pinch me in a minute. We recorded notes on the phone, so what else on the phone? While we're checking that, I was going to say the APAC meetup, but just quickly, the PyBytes meetup on Saturday was super special. We had everyone who is in our community who read the email or responded showed up, and we had this wonderful, wonderful time. We only had an hour, but we took everyone out for a beer and a cocktail, and then we came back, took a group photo, and it was just lovely to meet a lot of people who we've known for years. Who've been supporters. One of them, Chris Patty's, even been on our podcast. And then also getting to meet new people who we hadn't met before in our community, who just randomly reached out and said, yeah, I'll come along. And it was wonderful.
Yep.
Yeah.
And we will link the LinkedIn post with the photo.
Yeah,
we have see a lot of happy faces. And it's a special moment for us.
Exactly. We also have, we'll put a post in the Circle community as well.
Yeah. What do you want to say about APAC?
Oh, yeah, the PyCon APAC. So I didn't know there was an APAC version of PyCon or, you know, event. I thought in Asia Pacific, there were just the individual events country to country. So it was really nice that they brought the whole PyCon APAC team over, all the leaders of the different PyCons over there for Australia, Japan, Korea, Indonesia, whatever, and all the others. There's plenty more. And they brought them over and we got to chat. It was really, really cool to hear more about that. So my hope now is to be more involved in the Python PyCon space in Asia Pacific. And I'm hoping to go to the Indonesia PyCon APAC 2024.
Which I had a similar experience because I stopped by the booth of hablemosespanol.dev, from memory. So we speak Spanish. So
okay.
Yeah, big Spanish-speaking community. Yeah. They have a Discord, so I'm going to check it out. And, you know, you can search for this stuff online, but again, the serendipity, right, it just happens at PyCon. So it opens a lot of new opportunities you otherwise would not really have looked into if it was not for that, you know.
For that being there. Randomly walking around.
Yeah.
Now that was actually the other cool part is just by walking around, you just see all these new things. And it admittedly, I felt that this conference was not as big as Cleveland. So Bob and I both missed 2022 and 2023 in Salt Lake City. So we don't have that as a reference. But Cleveland felt a lot more packed. It felt like there were more people. It felt like there were more booths set up, and definitely at the Career Expo that was on yesterday, it felt very sparse over here.
Yeah.
It felt like there was, eight or 10 companies that came here for the Career Expo, but in Cleveland, there were heaps. I remember Pokemon was out there as well. Like, there were so many different things, and it was packed, and this was very empty. So hopefully, you know, we'll see more attendance pick up.
Sparse is better than dense, right? Instead of Python, but maybe for a conference, you want a bit more dense.
Yeah, not for a conference.
But there was also a little bit of a but, right?
Oh, yeah. So, you know, I highly recommend coming out to PyCon, of course.
The food was great as well.
Yeah, the food actually got a lot better too. Whoever they used for catering smashed it this year. It was I remember in Cleveland, some of the food was pretty, we had it once and we said, you know what, we're going to go eat down
and
the street.
They didn't have like high carb dips in the afternoon. It was like sustained energy.
Exactly. There were a lot of greens and veg.
There was a bit of a thing, right, with the masks.
So one of the polarizing things about PyCon 2024 this year, the mask mandate they had. So as you know, we're not going to go into the detail, but a lot of people were like, why are we doing this? And, you know, we put it on, we said, we'll play ball, we'll do it. The unexpected effect of that, and we're not getting into the politics here, I'm just going to call a spade, right? It made it very difficult to connect with people.
Not impossible.
Not impossible.
A bit more of a barrier.
So for example, you couldn't just see people across the floor and know that it was them, especially if you're looking for people that, say for us, like in our community, I don't know exactly what all of them look like. They might know what we look like, but even with the masks on our face, it makes it much harder. So perfect example, one of our lovely community members, Blaze, was standing there, he was looking after the PyCon, the PSF table on the first day. And while he was there, I walked past, and it was literally, and I told him this, it was literally because of his hair that I looked twice. I'm like, is that? And I had to stand there. I think we both stood there for a good 5 seconds staring at him, like creepy.
Oh, yeah, he had the badge, right? And the font on the badge was pretty big. Yeah. So that helped.
But we were looking.
It was a little bit weird.
No, we were looking side on first, right? And so you couldn't see the badge. So I'm like, is that Blaze? I think it is. Yeah. I think. But had the mask not been there, we would have seen it straight away. And then.
And then, of course, when you talk, it's a bit more difficult. But
to hear people, it was muffled and it was mixed. So to me, it really did detract from the experience. I understand why they wanted to do it. But for me personally, I found it quite annoying. And that's just an opinion. Yeah. But that's, that's how it goes.
Yeah.
So hopefully next year, they will, things will be safer for everyone and there will be more of a choice. So we'll see if that happens.
Then we had something about networking, right? And partnerships?
Yeah. So one other cool thing that's come from this is seeing other people using the conference for everything, for learning, but also the networking. Someone in our community, someone that we know, actually had a wonderful opportunity come up from this. They found there could be a potential employment opportunity. There's lots of calls that will be happening as a result. But it was a wonderful experience. That person was able to go around and hand out business cards, meet with these people, and when people said, hey, you should talk to so-and-so, they were actually to go and introduce them to the person. So it was really, really nice and uplifting to see that coming out to the conference actually can help people and will help people if they do the right things of networking and not being too afraid to reach out to people.
Yeah, of course, you do have to make a concerted effort, right?
Exactly.
Be interested, ask questions, and
So you just remember, you can be a passive participant or you can just say, this is an opportunity. I'm not going to squander it. If you have that goal, of course, I'm going to do something. And that's what this person did. And it looks like a wonderful opportunity is there to be snatched, So I love it.
Yeah, I think that's it. It's overall very inspiring. You see so many things. For example, one thing we saw again were physical books, and we were not reading physical books. Sparked kind of an interest and so there's a lot of next things and ideas we take out of this. But I think the takeaway, it's been said many times, right? You come for the Python, stay for the community. Mm-hmm. Thing really here has been the people.
Without a doubt.
Has been invaluable.
Yeah, we've had wonderful opportunities to chat and connect with people. We've met the founders for CodeSpeed.
Yeah,
plug
in to measure performance with every PR. So
again,
a lot of ideas.
Yeah, and I was very happy to see more Australians. That was cool, meeting some more Aussies in the room. That was fantastic. And I just think overall, even experiencing a new city can be very refreshing, and getting yourself out of that normal home environment that you're in, your home city, to go somewhere else really frees the mind. So as Bob and I, we've stayed a good 10 to 15 minutes away from the conference center walking distance, and it just means every day that we're walking, we're talking, we're coming up with ideas. We want to re-release our Python tips book. That's what Bob was hinting at, and in such a way that it's going to be a physical book. So there's all sorts of cool
and the career tips.
Yeah, exactly. So those things are coming. Now that's it. We have a few things to do before we go, but we fly home tomorrow. It's going to be a nice long trip back. I think I'm on the second longest flight that you can do on the planet. So Dallas to Sydney, 17 hours. It's going to be a long trip.
We're stacking up on books. So what are you reading?
Yeah, I'm reading. Well, I didn't buy this. So I brought this one. Thank you to my neighbor who let me borrow this book. Matthew Riley, Scarecrow. So I'm on, I think it's book 3 in that series. So fiction. I'm very happy to read that on the plane. And we also indulged and went to a bookshop yesterday. What'd you pick up?
Algorithms, Panos Louridas. Mm-hmm. How to Tell a Story, which is useful if you're posting to social media, or I think anybody has a story to tell, right?
Yep.
If you're a content creator or not, in 4,000 weeks. It's a long time on the list. Productivity book. A lot of people talking about it, so let's give it a go.
Time management for mortals.
And an LLM book. LLM book from Sebastian Rashka, the machine learning guy, so definitely going to read that.
Beautiful. All right. Well, everyone, a special shout out and thanks to everyone in our community who did make the time to come see us. A very special thank you as well to our coach and teammate, Hugh Tipping, who came from New York. So he came a long way, of course. No, I'm joking. But he came out here just to see us when an experienced PyCon as well. And we spent a lot of time with him, and it was wonderful. And then all of our friends here as well who made the time. It was just very, very special to be greeted with such warmth when we came all that way and were jet-lagged and tired. So it was very nice.
Special shout-out as well to Pamela's Diner.
Pamela's Diner in Pittsburgh. Amazing.
Yeah.
And the everyday for breakfast.
Yeah. Because I think we explicitly or implicitly had a bucket list item of refilling coffee.
Yeah, we don't in Australia, they don't have drip coffee. So you don't go to coffee shops and have them refill your coffee mug every 2 seconds. And that was super special. It was like a TV show.
But yeah, we got a good 3 cups of coffee and then we're good the whole day.
Exactly. Yeah. It's wonderful.
Amazing place. So if you're in Pittsburgh,
go check them out. And we don't get any affiliation for that. We're just saying that.
Purely out of...
So it's time to go brew a coffee.
Customer satisfaction.
And get back to work.
So. Yeah. Good checking in and join our community, pybytes.circle.so.
Yep.
And yeah.
We'll be back next week.
New exciting stuff.
Perfect.
All right.
All right. Thanks, Bob. Thanks, everyone. Bye.
We hope you enjoyed this episode. To hear more from us, go to pybytes.com/friends. That is pybit.es/friends and receive a free gift just for being a friend of the show.
And to join our thriving community of Python programmers, go to pybytes.com/community. That's pybit.es/community. We hope to see you there and catch you in the next episode.